Hello everyone, this is Chris from Spoon Graphics back with another video tutorial. Today we're going to play around in Adobe Illustrator to create a seamlessly repeating pattern. Since it's almost Halloween, or at least it is at the time of recording this video, we'll make a pattern out of spooky illustrations, then add a couple of cool finishing touches to give the artwork a retro style print effect with subtle ink bleeds and misregistration. The illustrations in this pattern are based on some quick sketches I did with one of those drawing stick tools they used to use in the olden days. So if you want to follow along with this tutorial, you can download the scan from the description area. Open up Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. You can give yourself a nice large work area by going to View and Hide Artboards. Go to File and Place and navigate to the scanned sketch image. Scale it down in size while holding the Shift and Alt keys, then reduce the transparency to 50% so it'll be easier to see the vector artwork over the top of it. Go to Object, Lock and Item to avoid accidentally selecting and moving this reference image out of place. Clear out the white fill from the default settings in the Fill and Stroke box, then select the Pen tool. Zoom into the first drawing and begin tracing it with a vector path. There's a few different techniques you can use with the pen tool, but I like to simply click and drag as I go. Then whenever I need a sharp corner, you can give the end point an extra click to remove the bezier handles. Whenever you want to leave an open end, hold the Command key while clicking on some empty space to deselect the path, so it doesn't continue onto the next point. Using Smart Guides, which are accessible under the View and Smart Guides menu, make it easy to snap to existing paths. It takes some practice to get a feeling for how much to drag out each handle to make the right size and length of curve, but you soon get the hang of it. Since the theme of this design is quite sketchy or doodly, it doesn't really require extreme precision. Any slightly wobbly lines just add to the cartoon-like style. Once you have a bunch of drawings traced in vector paths, move them to one side into some empty space on the artboard and collate them together. Draw a selection around them all and increase the stroke weight to around 3 points and add the round cap and round corner settings. Hold the Shift key and carefully select all the negative shapes that require a fill rather than a stroke, such as the eyes and mouths, then switch the fill and stroke settings around. Go to Object and Expand and hit OK to convert the stroked paths into solid outlines. Then we can produce a subtle bleed effect by going to Effect, Distort and Transform and Roughen. Change the point setting to Smooth, then change the size to around 0.3% and the detail to around 20. Draw a selection around all the illustrations and hold the Alt and Shift keys while dragging the shapes to create a duplicate. Change their fill colours to orange, then click the Unite option from the Pathfinder to merge the various pieces that make up each illustration into one outline. Right click and select Ungroup so they can be selected as individual objects. We want these orange shapes to be fully solid rather than outlines, so use the direct selection tool to delete the paths that form the inner parts of each shape. Select all the shapes and use the Unite option from the Pathfinder a second time to blend any leftover shapes into these main silhouettes. Move the shapes back over to overlap with the original versions with the black outlines. Rather than line them up perfectly, offset them slightly to give the design an old school print vibe. The orange backgrounds are currently sitting over the black outlines, so press Command Shift and the square bracket key, or right click and go to Arrange Center Back. Draw a selection around each individual illustration and press Command and G, or right click and select Group to join the two parts of each drawing together. Roughly rearrange the elements to space out the different doodles, then with them all selected, go to Object, Path and Make. This new pattern editor has been in Illustrator since version CS6, and it makes it much easier to create seamlessly repeating swatches without the hassle of carefully setting the bounding box. You can change the opacity of the preview so you can clearly see your original elements and how it affects the pattern when you move them around. Tweak the layout to fill any unsightly gaps in the pattern. You can then toggle off the tile edge setting and bring the opacity back to 100% to see a fully repeated example, which makes it much easier to see any awkward spacing. Hit OK in the top toolbar and your pattern will be saved in the swatches panel. This swatch can then be applied as a normal fill to repeat your pattern infinitely. Here's one extra pro tip, you can scale the pattern separately from its container using the Object Transform Scale command by selecting the Transform Pattern option. With the design being in vector format, you can scale it up or down as much as you want to alter the density of the pattern. So I hope you find these tips for creating patterns in Adobe Illustrator useful for your future designs. If you did, a like on YouTube would really help spread the word. You can also subscribe to the channel if you want to be the first to see my future tutorials. Or if you're watching this on YouTube, I have loads of written tutorials over on my website. So as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all later.